What's up, guys? So today's video is brought to you by all the sexy grooms out there that I've shopped. So today I want to talk about dramatic portraiture with the groom. And the reason I want to talk about it is because I feel like women, the brides, we get all the attention and the grooms really don't. So I usually don't have a lot of time with the groom, maybe 10 to 15 minutes. And so I wanted to talk a little bit about my process going into shooting the groom, actually shooting the groom, and just kind of what goes on in my mind beforehand as well. So my overall aim when shooting grooms is to make them look masculine, chiseled, cool, and sexy, very GQ. And the reason why I feel burdened to do this is because, think about it this way, what man seeks out a boudoir photographer? Not one. What man ever really gets his photograph taken besides the family photos that his wife makes him go to? So basically, this is the one chance in the man's life that he's going to look ultra sexy for his woman. In wedding photography, for some reason, we make the day all about the woman, and she does make a lot of decisions, I understand, and usually they've dreamed about this day ever since they were kids or whatever, but for the men, we kind of just brush them aside. I just feel like we need to give men a little bit more attention. I used to have the man, like my second shooter, one of my second shooters, I would have them go in and photograph the groom and I would photograph the bride and we'd be totally separate. And what I found was it doesn't have a cohesive story and I'm not able to get my vision across as well. So I make sure to photograph at least 10 minutes of the groom, just me and not my second shooter, because I need to have that time with the groom to, for something to match the wedding and to lay in the album. When it comes to personal, intimate shots, I can explain my vision to somebody, but it doesn't mean that they're going to feel the same way I feel, which means they're not going to get the same photographs that I get. So it's certainly not that I would be putting any of my second shooters or assistants down for not getting that shot that I need. It's just that we all have different approaches. So I have to make sure that I have a little bit of time with the groom myself to be able to get that story that matches. So I try to spend at least 10 to 15 minutes photographing just the groom getting dressed. Now, let me tell you what I mean by getting dressed. So basically, I want the groom to be dressed to pants, shirt, and socks when I come in, or shoes if they're not that important, like if he doesn't want to be photographed with the shoes. So if he has shoes that are important to him or he really liked them, we show those details while he's holding them. Of course, I photograph details, which I'll make a separate video on, but I photograph details by themselves. But one thing that I've found that I really, really like is showcasing the details with the human behind them, because the details are nothing without the human. So basically, like where I have the groom holding the shoes or holding the tie or whatever. As long as they're dressed up to that point, then I'm comfortable going in and they're comfortable with me being in there. Now they're gonna be uncomfortable getting their photograph taken either way, but they're at least more comfortable because they're dressed. So basically, I like to keep the groomsmen in the room with us. Yeah, they can get a little rowdy, but they do a lot in making the groom feel more comfortable in front of the camera. It's cool to have the groomsmen around because they usually make a lot of laughs. Like, men don't generally do that great in front of the camera, and it's because they're hardly ever in front of the camera or they're just being goofy. So for something kind of serious on their wedding day, a lot of times they can get kind of nervous. So it's good for the groomsmen to be around during this period. Plus, it's manpower. I'm a really tiny girl, and a lot of times I have to move things and stand on things to be able to get the shot or the angle that I want. So having the groomsmen there, they can just push stuff around super easy and just move everything that I need done. I think our approach to any shoot is extremely important. So I think whatever's going on in your head is really, really going to define how any shoot is going to go. You know, anything that you approach in a negative way probably is not going to go as good as if you approached it in a positive way, or you won't be as creative anyway. When I approach a groom, I think about, and I have to really open my mind a lot, especially if the groom kind of has a negative personality, but I have to really open my mind to see what their partner finds attractive about them, or what they find sexy about them. And so I have to tap into that to be able to get the pictures that I do. There's a lot to do with feeling. I think that photographs provide a feeling for someone. So even if the lighting is bad or even if the location is bad, if there's feeling behind the image, then people are going to gravitate towards it. Now, of course, as a professional photographer, I want everything to be perfect, but the feeling has to be there as well. Sometimes this process can make me feel really awkward, but I get through it because I want to provide the best photographs ever for my couples. Generally with men, and to get dramatic shots, one light source is acceptable. So I bring them to a window, which is my one light source. I usually don't have any sort of diffuser over the window because I want to create a chiseled look and I want to carve out the face with the light and the shadows. So basically, to get a very dramatic look, I just stick with the one light. Now, another thing that we need to take into consideration is that I want the man to look very masculine. So if the man has a very round head, then I want his head to kind of recede into the background. So if I'm exposing for the highlights of the skin at the window, and the person has dark hair, then generally it can recede into the background and I don't have to worry about the roundness of his head. Now, if he's got a very straight head, a very masculine head, then I might even put a reflector up to kind of just shine a little bit of light on the hair, or, you know, we can get creative at that point. If the person has a round head and I don't think I can make it recede into the background, then I will do portraits where I have cut in very far into the man's face to be able to get a more straight or V-type look rather than a round ball. Generally, roundness is associated with women and not men. So for men, we need straight lines. Men can do hard light a lot easier than women can, and they just look cool that way. Men are sexier when they're more rugged. So a hard light is not an issue. So generally I expose for the highlight. Being very short, I usually have to get up to a pretty high angle. I also like to fill the frame with the man for a lot of the photographs because it gives them a much bigger presence than if, say, if I photograph someone far away and they're like this small, then they don't have a huge presence. But when you're up in somebody's face and their whole being is in that photograph, then they have a huge, huge presence about them. That helps me tap into more of the masculine feeling that I'm going for. I've photographed a lot of men that are shorter or extremely lean, and they may not be that masculine, or extremely round, extremely large. And so my whole point in photographing them is to make lines, to make drama, and to make masculinity, which translates to sexiness and GQ when the final photograph is done. So while we're at the window, I get them doing their cufflinks and their ties, bow ties, suspenders. We might do a little bit of posing. Then they put their jackets on. If a boutonniere is present and the person that's going to be pinning it on them is present, we will do that right then at the window as well. So if the space is really cluttered or really messy, which it normally is for the groom and the bride, I'll do the bust shots at the window, and then we'll do more full body shots outside or in a different location for a couple minutes. But generally, I only have about 10 to 15 minutes with the groom. And that, just the groom by himself. So I have to get a lot done in a very fast period of time. Generally, I don't use any off-camera flash. It's all natural light because we have to get these things done. Generally, all I need is a small spot of a nice clean background, the top of a wall, and that's all I need to make these portraits. So I need a window, a wall, and a person. And then sometimes a reflector or diffuser, but that's all in one. I thrive on people seeing what I see when I look at them, or what I can see when I look at them, to make other people feel amazing about themselves, to reinvent people. I don't use Photoshop. I don't go in and make people thinner. I don't go in and, sometimes I'll take some pimples off or whatever, but I don't go in and change the inherent qualities of the person. I use what I have with me that day and sculpt with the light and the shadows. I love making people feel beautiful or handsome. I love making people feel good about themselves. And part of photography is that for me. Now, of course, there's the challenges that I thrive on a challenge. For the most part, I just love making people feel amazing about themselves. I feel like that's what I was made to do. That is my passion. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you might have learned something. I'm actually gonna take these photographs that I've shown you and I'm going to show you edits, the unedited and then the edits in the next video. Subscribe if this video helped you in any way or you think my channel will help you in some way. Sharing is caring, guys. So please share my video with someone who it may benefit. And also, if you did not like my video, please comment down below what I can do to improve it. And I thank you so much for being here. I'll see you next time, guys.